What's up again, everybody? So if you did not hear the news, Legend Story Studios has announced a second season of Skirmish events. The Skirmish series was a series that played out online via webcam, or it could have played out in person if you were playing in New Zealand. But essentially, the format was like a one-off tournament, and it was a blitz format tournament. So you'd build a 40-card blitz deck, you'd bring that to the tournament online, and you'd play your you'd play your Swiss matches, and perhaps there was a top cut, and then Legend Story Studios would send out prizing. So they announced a second season of Skirmish events, and this format is going to either be blitz again, or it could be sealed, and it could be Monarch sealed, which is really, really cool and a fantastic way to play the game. Sealed is actually probably my favorite format, period, end of story, just because it's so much fun to play. So I thought, you know what, I think this would be really fun. I went and I got out one of my first edition Monarch boxes here, and I'm going to open this up for the express purpose of making this video. We're going to grab six packs, and I'm going to build a sealed deck, and I'm going to show you exactly how I go about playing the format and trying to design a deck for the format. So I don't know what I'll do with the other packs in this. Maybe I'll open them on my channel. I don't know. We'll find out something else to do with them. But this is a first edition box. I have had some very crummy luck opening first edition boxes. So if you want to see the bad luck, if you want to see me just not hit the nuts, go check it out on my channel, which is youtube.com/DMArmada. I'm not even going to like shuffle it or anything. I'm literally just going to grab six packs. Get in there, thing. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So I'm not really looking to look at all those other packs in there, just waiting. I'm going to open those on the channel, which you should totally follow if you want to see me open them. I may do them in shorts. I'm not sure. But here's six packs. Okay. So again, as a sealed format, how it works, essentially, you're going to get six packs from whoever is running the tournament. You're going to crack all six packs, and you're going to make a 30-card minimum deck with those six packs worth of cards. At that point, after you finalize your deck, you can only use the equipment that you pull, but you can supplement your pulls with a hero and a weapon token from your personal collection. But the equipment has to come from these six packs. So really quickly, let's go ahead and open these six packs. I'm not gonna really dive too deep into the packs as we open them. I'm just gonna kind of open them and show you how I sort everything and how I actually go about thinking about what to play, what to build. Let's get this camera nice and close. Let's get cozy and comfy. Let's see if the focus is on or off. I mean, it seems pretty good, right? You guys can see the cards. I can see the cards. If we can both see the cards, then great. I'll go very quickly through each pack just so that we can kind of get an idea. And when you separate these out, I separate them by class. So I'm going to put them in this instance. I'm going to separate them like this by class. Boom. Here we have Void Wraith. I'm going to put this probably right there. Ghostly Visit, Illuminate, and Blood Tribute, Yinti Yanti. I'm not doing the normal pack thing. That's a generic, so it goes there. Pulping was the foil, which is cool. That one goes there. Hooves of the Shadow Beast is a fantastic equipment, so that's one equipment pile. Is very important to keep in mind. We have the Herald of Judgment. We have Howl from Beyond, and Don't Worry About the Token as You Go. This is an interesting token. It's the double-sided token there. But again, the tokens don't matter because you can supplement. As far as big pulls, I don't really care. It's not so much when you're playing in a sealed tournament, it's not really about what you pull so much as it is what you build with. I mean, you can have some absolutely terrible pulls. I'm gonna put that right there. That is the first Shadow Brute card we've pulled. That's interesting. It's not so much about like cards that you pull. It's really more about how you build it. Oh, I put this in the wrong pile. How you build your deck and how you execute it. Because I think some hugely important things are like what generics you pull, some of these kinds of things. Here we go, Foil Courageous Steel Hand, that's fun. Time Skippers is another cool equipment. That's 2 feet equipment, so we're kind of looking for some more stuff, more equipment. Equipment's a huge part as well of what you're gonna be building. Because if you get class equipment, it immediately should trigger your mind. Oh, I should think about playing that class. Bounding Demogon, Deadwood Rumbler's good. Wartune Herald, Courageous again, Herald of Protection. Those are good. Spew Shadow, Memorial Grounds, cool. You have Lunartide, right here. Eclipse Existence, Penetrable Belief. Oh my god. Oh my god. Okay, that's... We have to pause the video while I absolutely get just so hyped. That's a Cold Foil Majestic, and not only is it a Cold Foil Majestic, this is a Cold Foil Majestic Alt Art Galaxy Black. This is one, this is one of the hardest cards to pull, and not only that, this is my second one, because I pulled one in the first case that I opened. This is amazing. This card's fantastic. Oh my gosh, that is a beautiful card. Wow. Okay, so we'll put that over there. Gauntlet, Ironhide Gauntlet's good in Sealed. We have Dimensional Gateway, and the hits keep coming. Again, it's not so much about the strength of the pulls as it is what you can do. Exude Confidence is fantastic in multiple different decks, and multiple different heroes. That is a card that's probably going in any deck that you build in Sealed. I should sleeve this. Like, okay, I'm sorry. I wasn't expecting that kind of a pull. We should most definitely get that into a sleeve because that card is expensive. That is a nice, that's a nice card to get in a casual I'm gonna make a Sealed deck video. Oh man, that's a pretty one. Okay, we'll just set it off to the side. We have three packs left. We've only pulled a two Majestics. One of them was a Cold Foil Majestic. That's a, man, that's a hit. Holy moly. Okay, sorry, I have to bring my excitement down. I'm supposed to be building a deck here. Bounding Demogon, Hungering Slaughter Beast, Herald of Tenacity. We got the Express Lightning. Illuminate, Blinding Beam is a really important one to look at if you're thinking of playing Prism. Frontline Scout, Minnowism Yellow, Void Wraith. Ooh, and a Foil Seeds of Agony Red. That's a great card to get your hands on. And an Aether Ironweave is also really good. Seeping Shadows and a another Majestic Tear Limb from Limb. The hits, man. This card is really good. It's really good, period. It may be a little bit tricky. It just depends on your pool for Shadow Brute. Jeez, I didn't have sleeves ready because it was just going to be six packs. Who cares, right? Okay, I guess I had to have sleeves ready. Forget everything. Okay, so this is an interesting turn of events as well. I should put Exude into a sleeve because that's going to go into the deck no matter what. Tear Limb from Limb really makes me think about Brute, but we'll have to look at Shadow Brute. Oh, this is a perfect fit. Forget it. We'll just keep going. Not a big deal. So far, this has been weird pulls for the various different classes. Riftbind Yellow is a good card. Smash with Big Tree. Rifted Torment's a fantastic red. Courageous again. Herald of Rebirth red. Cross the Line Yellow. You have Impenetrable Belief. Warmonger's Recital red is just really good. So is Stony Wootenhog, in fact. Red Minnowism as well. Surging Militia followed by a Foil Blood Tribute, the first edition. And then we have Blood Drop Brocade, which is good. Seeping Shadows. And then a Vexing Malice. Wow, a Vexing Malice Yellow. Oof, that's really, really interesting for Shadow Runeblade. And the final pack, and then we'll look through this and I'll kind of talk you through my process for building a deck. There's a Cracked Bauble just in case we need it. We have a red Boneyard Marauder, another red Rifted Torment, blue Seeds, that's really good. Second Swing goes over there. Yellow Wartune. Wow, these last couple of packs are actually pretty solid on pulls. Adrenaline Rush is almost perfect. Lunartide for the yellow version is great. I put it in this stack because that's basically where it goes, but it does go down there. Warmongers again, Duskpath Pilgrimage for the foil. Going over there, we have the Gallantry Gold. Wow, some really good equipment there. Endless Maw is a good one. It attacks for five though, and then Tremor of Arathiel as well. Okay, so here's how I go about kind of processing all of this. And there is an extra step involved in Monarch Sealed that you don't have to do if you're playing like Welcome to Wraith, or if you're playing, I think these are all perfect fits, I'm done, whatever. That you don't have to do if you're playing Arcane Rising Sealed, and that is looking at your Shadow and your Light cards, but running through, and this is literally the first thing that I do, is I just count the number of class cards that you have. And I am including like regular Runeblade in with Shadow Runeblade, because of course, you can't play Viscerai, which is a regular Runeblade, in this format. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 is pretty good. Some of those are pretty good. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 with a tear limb from limb. So that is important to kind of think about. 11 is kind of small though. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. A few of these are good, but that is a very small number. And 10 just doesn't feel wonderful. It depends on the generics as well. And then for Warrior, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Okay, 11. So once you've done that, let's go ahead and look at our shadows and our lights. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Shadow cards, and this stack feels small. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Wow, very small. As far as generics are concerned, I mean, it doesn't matter how many we have. It really matters a couple of different factors. One, you want to look through your generics and find any that have 6 attack or more. And the reason that's good is because if you're playing in a sealed event and people are playing Illusionist, then 6 attacks are fantastic, and you're most likely going to find those in your generic slots. So like Stony Wootenhog, this card will be a shoe-in. No matter what deck I build, this will go into the deck. And the reason we know this is because if you look at across all of these cards, across all of these classes, none of them even came close to 30, right? So you're going to have to supplement a lot with generics. And this card can block, or can, you know, block, and then because it has a 6 attack thing, it will pop off the Phantasm effect on any of the Phantasm cards. So that's like an auto include. This becomes an auto include almost. None of these other ones block for 6, or they don't really block for 6. None of these other ones destroy Phantasm. But looking back through this, we do have some really fantastic, or functional, I should say, very functional generic cards for something like Shadow Runeblade, like Tremor of Arathiel. Not really Adrenaline Rush. Surging Militia is not a bad card, but a red Minnowism. Warmonger's Recital is just a generally good card. A yellow Minnowism. You could run that in Shadow Runeblade. Rise Above is kind of meh. Another Warmonger's Belittle is pretty good. These are good. Like Yenti Yanti are pretty good if you're looking to play Prism. You just have a good pool for Prism. But these are cards that stick out to me within that generic pool. And they would work for a... Technically, the Belittles and the Minnowisms would work for either Shadow Runeblade, of which we have the most class cards, or Light Warrior, of which we had a pretty decent number of class cards. So now let's jump back to the class cards. Let's look through Shadow Runeblade, since we did kind of pull a bunch of these generic cards that might work with it. So Seeds is always good. Blue Seeds is fine. Rifted Torment is always good. Seeping Shadows is just a really hard card to actually play because it costs 3. If you can pay for it, it's good because it gives the next attack action card with cost 1 or less. You play Go Again and +1, but it's expensive. Rifted Torment is always going to get played, so I'm putting that one down. Vexing Malice Yellow is really fantastic. Dealing 2 arcane damage is impossible to deal with in this format. Rifted Torment again. Riftbind is always good. Seeping Shadows Blue, I would run it because I can pitch blue. Seeds of Agony Red is just egregiously so good. Bounding Demogon as well. Red is really good. Again, Bounding Demogon's great because we have these seeds to access them. If we play a Seeds and then we play Bounding Demogon, then we're just comfortable, right? Dimensional Gateway is also really good. This one's good in this format. It's probably better in a format that you can control, like Blitz or Classic Constructed. But even in this, it's pretty okay. Bounding Demogon Blue, still worth running in sealed formats. Rifted Torment Yellow, still probably worth running in sealed formats. Namely because if you banish it and you attack with this, even though it costs 2, it will still push damage over the top, which is great. Riftbind's good. Even the blue one's good. And then Piercing Shadow Vice is kind of expensive for blue. If you can play this after dealing arcane damage, it comes in for 4. But this one's like a kind of a not great card. It is blue though, so I might just include that if I were playing that format. The only one here that's suspect to me is Yellow Seeping Shadows. But I'd probably still run it. It wouldn't be very fun to run. If we were to do that, what would we have here? This one would be an auto include because it blocks and has the ability to pop phantasms. So if we do, that's cool. Blood Tribute is not my favorite. You can make it work, but it doesn't block, and that's scary. Void Wraith, you could put it into to pitch for blue, but still not great. Eclipse Existence, Lunartide Plunderer again, that's probably another secondary include. Spew Shadows, no. Blood Tribute, no. Howl from Beyond, maybe. That's a maybe card. And the reason I say maybe is because it's expensive, but if you can play it, it can make something absolutely hard to deal with by giving plus three. And you could play it from your Vanish Zone. Ghostly Visit, solid. Void Wraith is not, I'm not a fan of Void Wraith. So it would be kind of tricky for me to pick Blood Tribute and put that into the deck, but these are cards, if I were playing Shadow Runeblade, that I would consider including for various reasons. Okay, is it even possible at this point to think about Shadow Brute? Let's see, Smash with Big Trees, really strong. Endless Maw is really good. Boneyard Marauder Red. Yeah, this is looking okay. Hungering Slaughter Beast is not great, but you can pitch blue for it, so it does become good. Two Deadwood Rumblers blue are fantastic. Yeah, this is doable as well. Pulping. Pulping could work. It could work, yeah. The fact that it doesn't block is a bit scary. And you know, the nice thing about doing Shadow Brute is that you can run the Hooves of the Shadow Beast, which we pulled. And that is a really, really strong card. Hooves is just a really, really strong card. We also do have Aether Ironweave that is available to us if we play Shadow Runeblade. So we'll put that over there. We'll put this over here. We'll put this one right there. Time Skippers is generic. The Gloves is generic. And the Blood Drop Brocade is generic as well. So the more equipment you can have, generally the better. And that's something you should also consider as well. So running quickly through these, there's just so few cards. Fortune Herald. Two Herald of Tenacities, though. I'm pretty sure that's really, really good. And a Herald of Ravages. All of these are yellow and red, which is cool. But you kind of want some blues mixed in. And if we were to supplement with our very small card pool, as you can see, there's very few blues that we can actually include. And it would just be a lot more generics that you would have to include in order to balance that out. There are very strong cards in here, but the fact that you don't have very many of them, and we didn't get things like Dreamweavers or really just anything that kind of combos with this stuff, makes it feel very weak. So I would just auto just delete that. I would just get rid of that. The other one that is worth considering, though, because we have so many cards and we have Gallantry Gold, is Light Warrior. So Cross the Line is a payoff if you charge. No, it does charge for you. Duskpath Pilgrimage is good if you're playing the weapons, but it can be a little bit tricky. It's not too bad. It's pretty good in its kind of form. Engulfing Light allows you to charge, and it allows you to give you this on-hit effect. So that's really good. Second Swing, solid if you're playing the weapon. Another Cross the Line, yellow, attacks for four. Courageous Steel Hand's really good for being able to push damage because it gives you the attack reaction plus two, and if you've charged, then you can use it. It also allows you to use the go again effect as an attack reaction. Express Lightning blue for pitching, Courageous Steel Hand blue for pitching, another Courageous Steel Hand. Yeah, this is doable as well. More Take Flights would have been good. I think more Take Flights is kind of necessary, but you could probably make do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. You could probably make do. The problem is that this is just such a small pool. Like, you'd include this and you'd include this. Seek Enlightenment and Illuminate in your deck if you're playing light anything, Light Warrior. But these cards are not great. Like, Impenetrable Belief is just not very good. The effect only triggers as like a defending thing. Blinding Beam would be good. Oh, there's a red Illuminate. That's good too. Blinding Beam would be good if you were playing Prism, but because you're not playing Prism, it's not really that applicable. The strength of these generics all being pretty good, like Minnowisms and things like that, alongside of playing small attacks, really does pull me towards Shadow Runeblade. But I don't want to discount the fact that we have what looks to be just a pretty solid options. You know, there's like pretty solid options here in Shadow Brute. I think another way to decide too is how many equipment can you run? If we use the hooves of the Shadow Beast, then we could run the Gauntlet and the Blood Drop Brocade. And that could be three equipment pieces just for a single character, which is great. If we use Shadow Runeblade, we get the Aether Iron Weave, which is a fantastic piece of equipment. And then we get access to Time Skippers, which can be good, and Ironhide Gauntlet, which can also be good. So we still get access to three. So to me, it just seems like I would want in this setup to play like a, especially with three equipment, to play a Shadow Runeblade deck. The biggest scare for this to me right now is that I don't have a ton of ways to deal with Prism and to deal with their large attacks. But if I do like that, and then I do like this from the cards that I've already pulled, and let's walk through this. Let's go ahead and clear some of this out, just in case we want to actually go. And again, we're kind of, we should not forget we have Exude Confidence as well. We're kind of ignoring the Majestic pulls just because they're fantastic, but they don't matter that much. If we're doing Shadow Runeblade, we get the access to these three equipments. And I'm going to go ahead and do this for us. Ka-chow. There we go. Access to these three equipments, which fantastic, solid, fine, solid. Especially, actually, this is one's really good in Shadow Runeblade. We would have Exude Confidence. We would want to play a Ghostly Visit because we can play it from Banished. Howl from Beyond is kind of a maybe. Lunartide is there for blocking, Belittles, Warmongers, Seek Horizons. Let me put the focus back because the focus is better right here. Kapow. Warmonger's just really solid. Minnowisms are really solid in this deck. Belittle. I thought I had one more Minnowism. Yeah, there it is. All right. Minnowism. Okay, so Seek Horizon allows you to set up like a banish for next turn or just like a redraw. You just redraw. It does take a card from your hand though, so maybe you just don't want to run it. It gives you go again though, so, and it's a four attack. Probably worth running. Warmonger's Recital is fantastic. Warmonger's Recital is also fantastic. In fact, they're even better in chain because if it hits whatever you're playing, you get to put it on the bottom of your deck and avoid decking out faster in chain. They do cost one. They are generics as well. They are non-attack action cards as well, and that's beneficial for certain effects in chain. Belittle is kind of fine. Minnowism and Minnowism are both good because they just buff up whatever you're playing. Most things that you're attacking with attack for three or less, and they'll just get plus three or plus two. Trimmer of Arathiel is cool. Stony Wooten Hog. Okay, so then you get to your class cards. This is the one that's the most kind of meh to me. And then the rest of these I thought were really good. They seem good. So let's break these. And this is the final thing I do is break them into colors and see how many resources we have at our disposal at any one time. So reds are all going over here. Yellow, red, lots of reds. That's a little bit scary. You kind of want a good mixture. For me, the way I like to play it, I want a good mixture of yellows and blues. So in this case, we would have, what is that, five blues. And in this case, we would have, what is this? Let's see. Something. Seven? No, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Yep. And then a whole bevy of reds. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13. So we have 20 and then we have 25. So if we include these, even if they're suspect, that's 27. So we have 27 cards at our disposal currently in the deck. So at this point, you then have to kind of just make some interesting decisions when you look back at the various cards that you have in your generic pool or some that you were just kind of meh on when it came to these. So these are our shadow cards. Eclipse Existence is something you can put in the sideboard. And yes, there is a sideboard in this format. You are able to basically say, hold on. I see that you're playing a light hero. I could put Eclipse Existence in. Blood Tributes, they're fine. You know what? I would actually consider... Interesting. I would actually consider playing a blue Blood Tribute because it pitches blue. And I can't get behind playing... Void Wraiths because, yes, it attacks for four or attack, or sorry, three or attacks for five, but it costs two and it's just going to stick in your banish zone. Spew Shadows, I'm just not a fan of that card at all. So deciding on these two is kind of... I would just go like that. I'd put them away. These would be... Maybe you run one Blood Tribute and maybe you don't. And then on the rest of this, we're not making auras, so it doesn't matter. We're not making auras. You could run this for the blue. Frontline Scout doesn't matter. It attacks for one. If you play it off of the arsenal, it gets go again. So it's worth considering. I don't know. It attacks really strong, but you can't give it go again because it's a generic. So maybe not. This card, I mean, if this were red, this would be auto in. That might still just be auto in. I don't know. Maybe. No. I don't know. It's just like it blocks two and it's free. But no, it's just not for me. Not for me. So this is what we're left with. Let's see. Counting again. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 16 so far. And then we have just a buku number. 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31. 31 cards with these as a possible throw in as well, just for extra resources. Your three pieces of equipment are all solid. Time Skippers is deceptively good in chain. Pitch a blue, gain two action points, do some extra stuff. You have some stuff that you could sub in, like an extra Blood Tribute, but I probably wouldn't. You have, I don't know, I wouldn't really include any of this stuff. If anything, I'm including maybe these because they attack for one, could have go again and just like add to your thing. We're already over 30, so we don't have to. But if you feel like you want the resources or the extra cards in deck because you're burning through your cards, then you could pop those in there as well. But this is essentially what I would put together with this sealed pool. I think this is what I would try to run. I think there's good cards in here. Obviously, the beauty of sealed is that you're not getting a perfect deck. You're not playing with a perfect deck. You're trying to work with what you've been given and make it happen that way. But there's a lot of decent cards in this, and I feel like chain in general plays well against most heroes. There's some scariness with like, man, you just launch a giant attack at chain and then he struggles a little bit. But the beauty of chain is that if you can live as chain player till the long game, then you can basically just turn your cards in hand into the cards you pitch to pay for the cards in your banish zone. So essentially, if you live to the long game, you can start stringing together your giant, absolute crazy, like go again turns. And so that oftentimes for me is the way that I've played chain and been successful with chain is like, okay, I'll deal some damage early, then I'll take some damage, and then at the end of the game, I'll just pop off with turn after turn until I burn out of cards. But usually I'll either win or lose right there at the end. And more often than not, chain, I've found, just wins at the end because it gets to the point where your opponent just can't deal with that many things. And that's pretty fun. Oh, also, we should play chain because we pulled this freaking card. Holy crap, this card's insane. We should definitely play chain for this exact reason. Oh man, what a sealed event. Pulling a cold foil. Alt Art Galaxy Black. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. If I could give you any like just super fast tips of what we just did, we opened all our packs, we split them into classes, we split into shadow and light piles, we put a pile for generics, we counted the number of class cards we had, we looked at what had the most, we kind of leaned into that with the incorporation of either the shadow talent or the light talent for Monarch here. And then from there, we started thinking about what would most be beneficial to put into the deck, how these cards in general are stronger or weaker, what the class wants to do. In our case, we wanted to go wide, so we included ways to go wide. And then we looked at the pitch costs and tried to figure out if we could find a nice balance of reds, yellows, and blues. And the reason there, by the way, is because if we only have red cards and these cards that cost like two fall into our hand, then we have to lose two cards from our hand just so that we can pay for the one card that we want to play. So having a nice mixture in this format is super important. That's what we did. I hope you guys enjoy this. If you want me to do this again, let me know in a comment below. Don't forget to hit the like and the subscribe here on Channel Fireball, and head on over to youtube.com/DMArmada if you want to see me open up the rest of these packs, because I may just keep doing this. This was fun. I liked building a deck from six packs. As always, everybody, thanks for watching.